Will you have success or be sabotaged by your stinking thinking? Will you have success? Will you do what God's called you to do? Will you handle the things? Now, there's things we need to let go of and things we need to hold on to. In my workshop, I talked about letting go of attitudes, letting go of emotions that are defeating you, letting go of past baggage and hurts, letting go of wrong thinking, wrong thoughts, the way you were programmed as a child. I also talked about letting go of toxic people out of your life. I'm not talking about your mate. I'm talking about the people that you employed, the people that you keep working and trying to please, the people you're jumping through hoops, the people that are criticizing you, and instead of you listening to God, you're trying to please them. And I shared about how you could never please people that can't be happy on the inside. One time we had a company trip, and there was one of the spouses of one of the people, and I planned this amazing trip to Hawaii. I put all these details, it was wonderful, and I decided Gary and I were gonna stay an extra week. Well, our money was really tight, and I'm thinking, okay, we stay an extra week, we'll do it super, super cheap. I don't care how we do it. We'll stay over in Hana. We'll stay over there. I'll find a house. A lady was renting a bedroom in and all this stuff. Well, another couple said, oh, you're staying longer. We want to stay longer too. We want to do your plans. I said, now look, we're doing this really, really, really right, bottom rung. I mean, I even looked at, can we sleep on the beach, right? So I looked at the lowest, you know, back then I was so frugal. You know, money tight. You go through some money tight times and you become very, very frugal. So I'm looking at all, thinking, how can we do this trip and do it so inexpensively? Now, this part that's supposed to be my rest time after we've done the company trip is now going to be other people want to stay. And now I've got their tour plans and now I'm the tour agent and I'm the one that has to put it all together. And so I keep telling them, selling them off it. Now we're doing this really cheap. We're staying in a really, and so I had to, then another couple went to stay. So they all stay. So we go the extra week. We go to Hana. We're staying in a lady's house. She's got like a little rental area. We're staying there. And others, I've got them in another rental area, similar kind of situation. And there's ants and there's situations, you know, and that kind of stuff. And so my gracious, I know I was in trouble because this one lady, she complained while we were staying at the gorgeous resort, right? And she's unhappy. I'm like, only a few people could be unhappy in Hawaii, unhappy in paradise. But you know what? It doesn't matter where you put someone. It's what's put on the inside of them and their attitude. And she had this attitude like, I dare you to make me happy. And I just took the dare. I kept trying. And it was so unsuccessful, may I say. Very unsuccessful. I knew we were in trouble because the resort part didn't go so well. She was miserable. She was unhappy with her husband. Something wasn't right. We're staying at the Hyatt Regency for Pete's sake in Maui. Who has a problem with that, right? And I'm thinking, oh no, oh no, oh no. And sure enough, second week came, we're sleeping in the really, really, really low accommodations. We're staying, you know, and all I heard was yakety, 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 yakety. You know, there's ants in the room. There's this, and then there's that. I'm like, kill them, do this, do that, whatever. Leave me alone. You know, we can't please people. You cannot live to please people. And I tried doing that. So I thought about quitting on marriage. And the Holy Spirit jerked me and said, no, you're not doing that. And I didn't really mean it anyway. I came back to the apartment that night at the City of Faith. I saw the big praying hands. I knew leaving was not the answer. I knew that was not going to fix anything and that I needed to change and I needed to grow. And there was stuff inside of me. It wasn't Pastor Gary. It wasn't Gary. It was Drenda. I had to face myself and I had to quit trying to blame someone else. One of the biggest things you can do to stay in a victim mentality and stay in a sabotage situation is to blame other people. The other thing is to justify your actions. Well, I cheated because of this. I did that because of that. I did this because, and then to complain. If you keep doing those three things, you're gonna stay stuck. And I was stuck. I had to make a choice whether I was gonna change and obey God or move on. And you know what? People move on. And what happens when they move on? They don't really move on. They move backwards. They move on to a second relationship and they bring the same problems and more problems because now they've got some baggage from the first relationship and the second one. And that's not to condemn anybody. I just want to tell you where you are is the best place to be. Work on where you are. Weed the garden where you are. Weed your thoughts. Deal with your emotions. Sit down and talk. Communicate. Gary and I had to learn to communicate. He was quiet and I was not. And so between the two of us, we had to learn communication styles. I had to learn to quit condemning him and saying things disrespectfully and pointing the finger and, you know, just coming off disrespectful. I had to learn to say things in a way he could hear my heart instead of hear criticism. So actually, we're going to talk about things not to quit. So there's some things you need to quit, but don't quit the right things. I'm going to encourage you that. Don't quit the right things. Don't quit on your relationship. Don't quit on your marriage. Don't quit on what God said to do. We started building a business, and the business became successful over time. It really did. We went through all kinds of stuff dealing with people and sales, and Gary would be the top salesperson in our company every month, and it eliminated a lot of excuses because you've got to lead by example. You know, you got to let people see it's possible to do it, or they don't believe it's possible. And so he would just look at people and say, hey, I'm doing it. If I'm doing it, you follow my model, you can do it as well. But inevitably, there'd be people that'd be like, I don't like the way you do it, Gary. I don't like the way your system. And they come up with all these heady systems. They got all these ideas and all this stuff that needs to be done, but they wouldn't make any sales. They'd be too busy criticizing what was working instead of doing what was modeled and just being teachable and coachable. So today, if that's you, you need to change that. You're going to quit. Somebody's going to quit on you. You can't do that. You got to keep staying in there. If you don't stay in there, you're not going to change. Do you want to end the war on sadness? Then click the button right there and subscribe.